Compatriots, today's briefing will be carried out by me. I'm Colonel Suren Sarumyan, the representative of the Defense Army of Artsakh. Within the last 3 or 4 days, the aggressor concentrated its efforts in the direction of Shushi. In this period of time, there were very heavy battles, and our units of our army were defending, and they were defending, are defending one of the symbols of our district, Shushi, the castle town of Shushi, and they are ready to carry out their duty with dignity. During the day, the aggressor carried out offensive towards Shushi, so those groups were found out and they were severely hit and they had lots of losses. By the way, we managed to imprison 2 Azeri soldiers. So the adversary has initiated offensives in other parts of the front line. Our troops have taken better defense lines, and during the day he destroyed 1 tank, 4 vehicles, and 8 drones. As a result of the activities in South East, our troops managed to take as a trophy 1 tank and a couple of artillery systems. Currently, the fights around Shushi are underway. There is some nuance. During the logic of the military activities assumes certain development of those activities and certain time period when those activities are taking place. And we can speak about the results of those military activities as a whole when they are close to their end or they have ended already. And I would like to assure our compatriots that the geography of these military activities also assumes certain confidentiality. Sometimes it's not really wise to talk about even the seized new territories. In any case, we have nothing to hide from our people. Please trust the official information and rely only on official sources of information. So one of the peculiarities of the military activities is that the Azeri side managed to penetrate in some directions penetrate the territory of Artsakh, and those territory which is considered to be the safety zone, our retreating was done because of tactical considerations. Well, when we are in the plains, it is better to take better position on the hills. It's better to retreat and get on the hills in order to fight more efficiently against the adversary and to hit more of their soldiers and armory. But those actions that have been carried out in the territory of Artsakh by adversary will not be forgiven. Our army will punish them and will carry out their duties. So the spirit of our soldiers is very high. There is no pessimism. Guys are strong by soul and they are ready to defend till the end their motherland and to carry out their duties. As usual, the adversary, having defeats from our army, they try to revenge the civilians, and they again struck the civilian objects where there are no military facilities. And this is a war crime, and that they strike at civilians. Now the operative situation is under the control of the units of Defense Army of Artsakh, and I can assure that victory is going to be ours. Let's talk about the questions. There are some couple of political questions. I'm not going to answer those. daily Shirjapat. Perhaps you talk about the situation honestly. The video that was put into circulation by Azerbaijan, was it a true one? Did they manage to put a flag on, install a flag on this place? When the leadership of the adversary sets some political or PR goals and they are, don't care about the prices they pay, so, and I can assure you that in a, during any war, it's possible that one recon raider group can manage to penetrate in any territory and to install a flag at the expense of being completely eradicated. And if they are ready to install flags, hoist flags, and then being killed, all of them, then we are ready to accept this kind of activities from their side. As far as the hitting of the Russian helicopter concerns, so what are the details that Armenian side knows about this incident? So the Russian helicopter was flying, escorting the vehicles of the Russian military base, and it was hit by a rocket that was launched from the territory of Nakhichevan. Yesterday, Artsakh Hovhannisyan stated that he was assuming that the fights for Shushi today will end. Do you think that he had some grounds to make this kind of statement? Does this statement have something to do with the statements that were made by the press secretary of the president of Artsakh? Well, while doing forecast of the military activities, you usually use, one usually uses certain data, but the current fight is a dynamic process and it assumes a lot of quick changes, which is not always possible to forecast. So there are no more questions. So this much, thank you.